The second fundamental theorem of integral calculus. Let small g from closed interval ab to r be an integrable function, and for x element of closed interval ab, define capital Gx equal to integral a to x gt dt. Then capital Gx is continuous on small g is continuous at some point c element of closed interval ab, then capital G is integral a to x dt dt is differentiable, and the derivative of capital G at c is small g of c. Here the result has two proof has two parts. First we want to prove first we assume g small g is integrable and prove capital G is continuous. Here to prove capital G is continuous, we prove that capital G is uniformly continuous. If a function is uniformly continuous, then that function is continuous. Using Lipschitz function, what is Lipschitz condition? A function f from a to r, a set capital A to r, is Lipschitz on capital A if there exists a constant m greater than 0 such that modulus of f of x minus f of y divided by x minus y is less than or equal to m for all x not equal to y in capital A. If the function f satisfies this condition, then we say that or modulus of f of x minus f of y is less than or equal to m into mod x minus y. If a function satisfies this condition or this condition, we say that for all x not equal to y in A, then we say that the function small f is Lipschitz on capital A. Okay, we use this definition here. Okay, first we want to prove capital G is continuous. Let small x comma small y element of closed interval AB, where x greater than y, here x not equal to y is the condition, then modulus of, what is modulus of gx minus, here we want to prove gx is continuous, what is modulus of gx minus dy is equal to capital gx is this integral a to x gt dt. So we can write integral a to x small gt dt minus integral a to y small gt dt. Here x, this is a, this is b, here this value is x and this value is y, because y, x is greater than y, what is integral a to x, integral a to x is from this point to this point, minus integral a to y, integral a to x gt dt minus integral a to y gt dt is integral y to x gt dt. that is modulus of capital Gx minus capital Gy is equal to modulus of integral y to x gt dt. Y to x gt dt. We have integral a to b fx dx. Modulus of integral a to b fx dx is less than or equal to integral a to b modulus of fx dx. We already proved this result. Then this can be written as less than or equal to integral y to x mod gt dt. That is modulus of gx minus gy less than or equal to integral y to x mod gt dt. We already have given g is integrable, so we already have a function is Riemann integrable, that function must be taken as a bounded function. We have, by definition, we have g is bounded function. G is a bounded function. G is a bounded function which implies there exists a constant. So there exists a constant m greater than 0, so that modulus of gx is less than or equal to m for all x belongs to closed interval a b. അല്ലെ, നമ്മൾ അങ്ങനെയാണല്ലോ എടുക്കുന്നത്. ഫംഗ്ഷൻ ബൗണ്ടഡ് ആണെങ്കിൽ നമ്മൾ അത് റീമാൻ ഇന്റഗ്രലിലോട്ട് ബാക്കി കൺവെർട്ട് ചെയ്യുള്ളൂ, ബാക്കി ഡെഫിനിഷൻ പറയത്തുള്ളൂ. അപ്പോ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് മോഡുലസ് ഓഫ് ജി എക്സ് മൈനസ് ജി വൈ ലെസ് ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു ഇന്റഗ്രൽ വൈ ടു എക്സ് എം എം ഇൻറ്റു ഡി ടി. So this is equal to m into integral of dt is t y to x. So this is equal to m into x minus y. We have x is greater than y. So gx minus gy, capital Gx minus capital Gy less than or equal to m into modulus of x minus y, because x minus y is same as mod x minus y, x is greater than y. So we can write this as modulus of Gx minus Gy divided by modulus of x minus y less than or equal to m. That is modulus of gx minus gy divided by x minus y is less than or equal to m. Hence capital G is a Lipschitz function. Capital G is a Lipschitz function in closed interval AB. Therefore, a function is Lipschitz, then we say that function is uniformly continuous. We have, therefore, capital G is uniformly continuous on closed interval AB. the function is Lipschitz, then it is uniformly continuous. So capital G is continuous. Capital G is continuous on closed interval AB. So first part is all. A function small g is integrable, and for x element of closed interval AB, capital Gx is equal to integral a to x small g t dt, then capital G is continuous on closed interval AB. Is finished. In the profile, in the down, if G is continuous at some point C, then G is differentiable and G dash C is equal to small g C. Given G is continuous at C. Given G is continuous at C. Given, next given, G is continuous at C. Small g is continuous at the point C. Continuous at the point C. Therefore, given epsilon greater than 0, by definition, given epsilon greater than 0, we can find a delta greater than 0 such that modulus of gt minus gc less than epsilon for modulus of t minus c less than delta. Take it to 1. This is the definition for the continuity. Definition of continuity. P is continuous at the point c, so given epsilon greater than 0, we can find a delta greater than 0 such that modulus of gt minus gc less than epsilon for t minus mod t minus c less than delta. Here we will prove that. Here g is continuous. We want to prove that g is differentiable and g dash c is equal to small g c. How to prove a function capital G is continuous, is differentiable? How to prove a function is differentiable? A function is differentiable if the limit exists, the limit extending to C, gx minus gc by x minus c. Limit extending to C, gx minus gc by x minus c exists, and we want to prove this value is taken as capital G dash C, and this is equal to g of C. To prove a function capital G is differentiable at the point C, we want to prove G is differentiable at the point C and G dash C is equal to small g C. To prove this, we want to prove the existence of this limit. Limit extending to C, Gx minus Gc by x minus C is equal to G of C. We want to prove this limit exists and this value is same as G of C. Okay. For this, consider Gx minus capital Gx minus capital Gc by x minus c is equal to 1 by x minus c into what is capital Gx. Integral a to x gt dt minus what is integral, what is capital gc, integral a to c gt dt is equal to 1 by x minus c. Here a, b, c is here, if x is here, then a2x and a2x here we take a b c and x here. What is integral a to x minus integral a to c is integral c to x. So this is integral c to x gt dt. So capital Gx minus capital Gc by x minus c is equal to 1 by x minus c into integral c to x gt dt. Taken at 2. Next, we have g of c. What is g of c equal to g of c? No problem. And multiplying and dividing by x minus c by x minus c is again same as g of c. So g of c is equal to g of c into g of c by x minus c. Numerator x minus c can be written as what is integral c to x 1 into dt. Del c to x 1 into dt is x minus c. Okay. So replace the numerator x minus c by integral c to x dt. We have gc is a constant. So gc is equal to 1 by x minus c into integral gc is constant. So integral c to x gc dt. We choose gc as like this. 1 by x minus c into integral c to x gc dt. Okay. Taken this as 3. Now using 2 and 3. Or 2 minus 3. What is equation 2 minus equation 3? Equation 2 gx minus taking a modulus. Modulus of gx left side, gx minus gc by x minus c minus here equation 2 is this gx minus gc by x minus c is equal to 1 by x minus c into integral c to x gt dt. So equation 2 minus equation 3. Modulus of equation 2 minus equation 3 implies modulus of gx minus gc by x minus c minus g of c. Is equal to modulus of. This is 1 by x minus c into integral c to x gt dt. 1 by x minus c into integral c to x gt dt minus what is g of c? G of c is integral 1 by x minus c into integral c to x gc dt. 1 by x minus c into integral c to x gt dt. So this is equal to modulus of gx minus gc, capital Gx minus capital Gc by x minus c minus gc is equal to, here 1 by x minus c is common, modulus of 1 by x minus c into modulus of, or 1 by x minus c into integral c to x gt dt minus integral c to x here gc dt modulus on the is equal to modulus of 1 by x minus c into, this can be written as, this can be written as integral c to x, here gt dt, here gc dt. So this is gt minus gc dt. This is modulus of, again we apply modulus of integral is less than or equal to integral of the modulus. So this is equal to 1 by x minus c into integral c to x modulus of gt minus gc dt is less than or equal to modulus of gx minus gc by x minus c minus g of c less than or equal to this integration. Here we apply the definition of continuity. Here modulus of gt minus gc less than epsilon for t minus c less than delta. So again hence for x element of AB such that modulus of x minus c less than delta implies using 1 we get modulus of capital Gx minus capital Gc by x minus c minus small gc less than modulus of, here modulus of gt minus gc less than epsilon. So less than 1 by x minus c into integral c to x epsilon dt. So this is equal to 1 by x minus c into epsilon into, taking integration we get t and applying limit x minus c, so both x minus c are cancelled, here we get epsilon only. So modulus of gx minus gc divided by x minus c minus small gc less than epsilon. For every epsilon greater than 0, for given any epsilon greater than 0, we can find this condition. So we have, therefore the distance between gx minus gc by x minus c minus gc is equal to 0. Gx minus capital Gx minus capital Gc by x minus c minus small gc is equal to 0. taking the limit. Now limit extending to c, gx minus gc by x minus c minus small g of c is equal to 0. Limit extending to c, gx minus gc by x minus c is equal to g of small g of c. This is definition of
sir break around.
Kelkunnille here ivide kittiyo idu clear aano ee line clear aano hello this is capital G dash C is equal to small g c. This is limit extending to C, gx minus gc by x minus c is capital G dash C, and this is equal to small g c. Therefore capital G is differentiable, and differentiable at C, and capital G dash C is equal to small g c.